Hello everyone and welcome back to my LEGO series. As usual, thanks for coming back. And here is your fight card for today. We got Tantrum taking on Shatter as our first fight. We got Chomp taking on Titan in our second match. We got none other than Fight Force and Dragon King in our third match. We got none other than the British Beta taking on P1. We got Quantum taking on Ice Wave in Fight 5. And Rotator and Riptide in Fight 6, which is our main event. Those are all of today's matches. And as per usual, I got nothing else to say. So let's hop right in. Here we got Tantrum being rolled into the arena with its weird looking top panel angle thingy that is designed to keep Shatter at the front of Tantrum. Here's Shatter with its special little armor. Those forks are not as durable as you think they are, but Shatter also has that absolutely devastating hammer, but still hasn't proved itself to be that strong yet. Both bots in the arena now are testing their weapons. Ready? 3, 2, 1, let the bot battle begin. Tantrum now trying to get under Shatter. Both bots are locking horns. Tantrum trying to get a nice hit but can't with just the long forks and chunky armor of Shatter. Shatter continuing to whack away. Tantrum getting under Shatter again, pushing him towards... Never mind, wait. Yeah, he pushed towards the wall. Tantrum trying to get some real damage going, but Shatter's just slowing that spinner down before it can even get spun up. Oh, and also, in case you haven't noticed yet, I am sick today. So I'm trying my hardest to keep this commentary well, and yeah. Not much else really. Okay, what should I choose for today's commentary? Or not commentary, like podcasting. Maybe the Desire Shatter? No. Or how about I actually commentate on the fight? Okay, Tantrum has lost its side panel, one of its self-riders, and seems to just be pushed around. I thought I was stuck on something, but apparently not. Oh, Tantrum now high-centered on its own forks, but it gets down. Tantrum's trying to fight, but Shatter's using those long forks to keep Tantrum away and using that hammer to keep his spinner down and get the damage points for Shatter up. Shatter continuing to whack on the other side of Tantrum now. Tantrum now has lost both sides of his armor and all he has left is his weapon, his front piece or panel, and one of his self-riders. Wait, never mind, he has no self-riders remaining. So if Tantrum gets flipped, that's it. And Tantrum has now lost one of its forks and side panel, or not side panel, front panel. Tantrum now just has one fork, one front panel, and its weapon to defeat Shatter with. Tantrum now getting... Oh wait. Oh yeah, I realized Shatter also lost one of its forks. Tantrum got under Shatter there, but doesn't have the stuff it needs to under Shatter. Shatter dealing a few more blows as his clock ticks down, and that's gonna be it for today's match. For this match, not today's match. Wait. Is there a today match? Anyways, the points are 3 points for damage, 2 points for control, and 2 points for durability/functionality. after the match. And the winner is none other than Shatter. Shatter with an impressive showing and is now 2-0. Probably should have brought my schedule book, because then I would have done a little spoiler alert for what Shatter was, or for who Shatter was playing to that fight. I wish I really didn't get my words correct. Next up, we got Titan and Chomp. Let the bot battle begin. No offense, but both these robots are kind of not the most entertaining, so I'm not surprised if you skip this part. But hey, I'm doing this and I'm not being paid to do it. Titan now drilling away at the top half. Yeah, I probably should have mentioned for those who might just be listening to the audio that Chomp was just flipped and is now being just ripped apart on the upper half by Titan, as Chomp's just stuck upside down. Chomp doesn't have a self-righting mechanism, as most of you should know, and it's split in half. Okay, you gotta disrespect Chomp like that. And Titan will take the win. Titan is now 1-1 like many competitors. And next up is a surprising fan favorite, Dragon King, taking on the real life three-time champion, Bite Force. Let the bot battle begin. Bite Force now pushing Dragon King into the wall. Dragon King really needs to have a good showing after its match against Witch Doctor, but it just can't get under Bite Force. Bite Force is just pushing Dragon King around. Dragon King's doing a nice job of slowing down that spinner, even if that means the absolute annihilation of his weapon, his crusher. Those little saw blades or discs have not been very effective at all for Dragon King yet. Dragon King now seems to have a loose back panel. It's now kind of flopping around. Oh, and Bite Force rips off a chunk of that floppy back panel. And Dragon King just uses Bite Force like a ramp and goes flying above him. Dragon King now close to the wall. Will Bite Force finish Dragon King off? No, he won't. Dragon King's not that easy to get rid of. Dragon King is now has inverted tracks. That's kind of weird, but I guess that's just Dragon. I can't tell by the ding-dang blind spot of the arena, but I think Dragon King's out. Bite Force is 1-1 now. And now we have the race car and the hammer. P1 and Beta both getting ready inside the box. Beta with that heavy hammer and P1 with that low ground. Let the bot battle begin. P1 immediately gets under Beta and almost flips him out. Beta was just barely saved by the wall, and Beta now P1's under Beta again, using that flipper to push him against the wall. Beta smacking on top of P1. P1 trying to push Beta around, but Beta is not being such a pushover. Beta now has P1 right up against the wall and is using that hammer and whacking down and down and down. Oh no, P1's flipper is damaged. I've actually never seen that before. P1's flipper is actually broken. That's not very easy to do, because P1's flipper is nicely socketed into the rest of the frame. Beta continuing to smack down on other parts of the robot of P1. P1 can do nothing but just wait until Beta stops, which he does. P1 now trying to get around Beta, but Beta is just using that wedge to stick to the side of P1. and P1 is split into two pieces. P1 is down. I have never seen that. I've never seen a robot be split in half by a hammer. Wow, Beta is now 2-0, and we'll see him again against Copperhead. Next up is the best crusher here, probably because there's only two crushers. In case you haven't gotten it yet, it is none other than Quantum and Ice Wave. Now the bot battle begins. Robots activate, alright. And Quantum immediately gets over to that disc on Ice Wave and starts to crush down. Ice Wave gets it spinning, but its spinner just does no damage. Ice Wave really needs to rethink that blade design, because right now, he's basically useless. Quantum now crushes down on the lift on the weapon and does a full little whip and smacks Ice Wave onto his side. Quantum now crushing onto the top panel of Ice Wave, and Ice Wave's weapon might be down because of that, but we won't even see if his blade works because Ice Wave is stuck, and Quantum will take his redemption win and his 1-1. And it's main event time. We got Riptide coming in from the little tunnel, showing off its little forks and its big nasty drum. Here's Rotator with its side armor, forks, and chunky little horizontal blade. Rotator came out of an easy win against Nightmare, and Riptide came out of a loss dominated by Shatter. As we've seen how good Shatter is, there's no shame in losing to him so far. Let the bot battle begin. Rotator trying to get under Riptide, but Riptide pushing, hitting Rotator, and Rotator finally gets under Riptide, pushes him into the wall. As Riptide tries to escape, but Rotator continues to just go on the offensive. Rotator is going on weapon hit, and of course Riptide gets the better of that exchange. Rotator going back to the forks and somehow flips Riptide. I'm confused on how that works, but I don't know, ask Mr. Physics Man in the corner. No, there's no Physics Man in the corner, I'm just joking. Rotator now trying to get some heavy damage on Riptide, but can't seem to get that spinner to a deadly speed. Rotator's not have as big or as heavy of a disc as some other robots. Cough, cough, Deep Six. Rotator, now is Riptide stuck up on its side, and will he leave him? Yes, he will. Rotator is now 2-0, but those wins have been pretty easy. Maybe Rotator can prove itself in its next match against none other than Overhaul. That is all for today's episode. Thanks for coming. But first, I have a special announcement. For those who are all here for the entirety of Hyperlash, thank you. Even if you're new, thank you. I would have never thought a year ago that I would get to maybe 300 subscribers. I know you might be looking at me and go, hey, you don't have 300 subscribers yet, but we're getting pretty close, and I don't really want to make a full video because I don't have anything planned for my little checkpoint. Anyways, thank you all for all the support through the past 2 years, and yeah, there's not much else really with the Hyperlash channel. Thanks to all of the other creators, thanks to all of the fans. That's all, and I'll Hyperlash, we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching Hyperlash.